Hello guys, this is a note on your hydraulics. What I'm trying to do here is to just overview the hydraulics, give you the summary, and in the next video I can straight away do calculations. So I'll just give you a brief summary. On the other side it's just a summary of your equations. On this side I'll try to explain what hydraulics is. It's a similar hydraulics to what you started before. What you could see here is a structure, a symbol of how hydraulics work. This side A, we call it a plunger, and that other side we call it a ram. You could see here, this is a pivot, where this is a lever which will move up and down. So as you apply an effort here, it will move around this pivot. So this is a pivoting point where it can, which allows the up and down movement of a lever. As you apply an effort here, your force of a plunger is being exerted, and then it pushes the plunger down. This distance is your H, a maximum distance your plunger moves as it's moving up and down. So if it's moving up down, it pushes a fluid inside. You will have a fluid, so you exert a pressure on your fluid, then your fluid will move and then it will be pushed upward. So what is your aim? Your aim is to allow this fluid to do work here on a plunger. So it have to leave this in here on a ram. So it have to move this ram up a certain distance. So this is H, a distance that will be moved by the ram. So your aim as you're pushing your effort is to allow a fluid to do work here so it can move this load a certain distance. So obviously that is the main purpose, that this hydraulic machine has to move the load. So your hydraulic fluid here will have to use what is called your Pascal's law. So all your hydraulics machine are operating on the principle of a Pascal's law. What is your Pascal's law? When you exert a pressure on the surface of a liquid, those forces will be exerted with the same intensity throughout a liquid. In other words, your forces are equal throughout. The pressure is equal throughout the system. Characteristics of a fluid is very important to understand the operation of your hydraulic machine. The pressure is equal throughout, it's available to do work at any junction. It is infinity, incompressible. It takes the shape of the container. So that is some of the characteristics of your hydraulic fluid. Now, these are the terminologies that we use. Your effort, which is E, it is being applied there, the force of a plunger, it's FP. Force of a ram will be a W since it's a load, it's a weight of a ram. And then you can have a mechanical advantage, which would be MA, diameter, two diameters, one of a plunger, one of a ram, small d and bigger d. And then your length of a plunger, that is small h, your distance moved by the plunger. And then the distance moved by the ram, it's big h. Now, the first equation will be your force. Pressure is force over area, measured in Pascal. Newton per meter squared is Pascals, or it can be kilopascal, depending on the magnitude of your pressure. So this is the first equation that you are using. And then you apply it now, what is called your Pascal law. Pressure is equal throughout, meaning pressure at A, which is a plunger, is equal to pressure at B, which is a ram. With this equation, you can now derive this equation. That is where this equation has been derived, because you have a force of a plunger over area of a plunger is equal to force of a ram over area of a ram. I put my force on one side and put my areas on the another side, then you can have this equation. Pi over 4 will cancel pi over 4 if you put area on the other side. So this will be a very common equation that we'll use. However, if you are not giving diameter, then you are giving as areas, then you can, instead of d squared, you put your area. But this is the first most important equation that you must remember. How it's being derived? Pressure at A is equal to pressure at B, meaning pressure at a plunger is equal to pressure at a ram. You can just play around it if you want to know how I came up with this equation. Put your force of a plunger over area of a plunger is equal to force of a ram over area of a ram. Put your areas on one side and your force on another side. Pi over 4 becomes pi over 4. Then you can have this equation. Volume. Volume is always area times distance moved in meter cube. Now, you may have two types of volume that you can calculate. A volume of a plunger, you have to add the number of strokes, how many times you've pushed the liquid. So the volume of a plunger, its area multiplied by distance moved by the plunger, multiplied by number of strokes. If they didn't have the number of strokes, then you take it as 1, we ignore the number of strokes. And then you can have the volume of a ram, where it be area of a ram multiplied by the distance moved by the ram. This is the equation for a volume. Now, again, what you need to take note is volume displayed by the plunger times number of strokes will be calculated volume moved by the ram. It is what you need to remember. In other words, the volume of a plunger is equal to the volume of a ram, because so plunger is your input here. So the volume of a plunger times number of strokes is equal to volume displayed by your ram. Now, if again you can put an equation for a area for your volume in a plunger, then you put an equation for your volume in your ram, you will have this equation: your pi, your area, you will have area times distance moved, pi over 4 d squared, pi over 4 equals the power over 4, and then you can have this equation as a number of strokes. Remember, if you have an efficiency, you have to put your efficiency, but if they didn't give you efficiency, you ignore it. Now, you will have this equation. You just need to memorize this equation, but this is your basic equation that you find on the formula sheet. It being derived from this equation, volume of a plunger times number of strokes is equal to volume of a ram. Pi over 4 will cancel pi over 4, then you can have this equation. You write down this equation, you memorize it. Work done. This W point D, it's a work done. I didn't put down it here, but it's standing for work done. Now, this is your energy. General formula for work done, force times distance. It can be the force of a plunger multiplied by H, or it can be W multiplied by H. That is your work done, your energy, in joules. So it measured in joules. Now, what you also need to remember about the work done is work done by your plunger is equal to work done by the ram. So work done of a plunger is equal to work done of a ram. Lastly, it's your mechanical advantage. Mechanical advantage is the ratio of an output force over input. Now, if your mechanical advantage is 5, that means your output force of a plunger is 5 times more than your input effort. If it's a mechanical advantage of a press machine, that means it will be W over FP. And then they say your mechanical advantage is 6. So your output force in a ram is 5 times bigger than your input. So that is what is a mechanical advantage, a ratio of an output over your input force. So this is a formula for a mechanical advantage of a lever. You might have a mechanical advantage of a machine, which will be W over FP. But this is a one of a lever, which is FP over effort times 100 over efficiency. If you are given an efficiency, if they didn't give you efficiency, you ignore it. I'm just trying to make it as short as possible. If you have a book, you can review it. If you have any question, I will check it on the section box. What I will do right now, I will just give you an example. On my next video, I'll do an example. You write these equations down, study them. Do remember the names. In 3.1, write it a pressure, and then write a formula for a pressure, Pascal's law. Know all the terminologies before you attempt to solve a problem. You might also take into account that your textbook might use a different method. I mean a different terminology. They might use a different terminology, but the principle is the same. Try to understand the principle. Look at a textbook. If you need more notes, talk to me in on the section box. I will attend your question. My next video, I'll do an example of hydraulics. Thank you, and then thank you for your support. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you for subscribing. I will catch you on my next video.